Let's get started. We're gonna make some Frenchy toast. Texas stick toast. Cinnamon. Vanilla extract. I got the cheap ass poor one. Splenda. For one serving, just one, we're gonna make two, so we're gonna use two. 45 calorie bread. So there's two ways of doing it. It's gonna be Texas toast. I like it. It was about five bread that it takes. It's gonna be a little bit more calories, but I like it. It tastes a lot better. Or you could get the 45 calorie bread, and that one is gonna be eight slices. So we're gonna do both at the same time though. I mix everything and I blend it. You can just literally put it in a box container and just shake the fuck out of it. Super, super simple. So we're gonna pretend we're making one serving. Whenever I say serving, all the bread in one, you just literally split that up into different meals. I can tell you about it later on. But one, boom. I put about two tablespoons. So I just dump it in there. I don't really count it, measure it, whatever. There's gonna be a splash of vanilla extract. Or about two. And then the Splenda, I actually do use a spoon. I use a ungodly amount to the point when I swear to God one day I will wake up with, I don't know, horns or something weird. Let's see how many tablespoons I actually use. Alright, so 2.5 tablespoons. There you go. Gonna blend that. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4 ingredients. If I miscounted that, it's because I can't even count. So this one gets a little bit foamy after you blend it. Oh well. Five, super thick boys. Boom. Then eight of these. Sweet. All right, so this has a smoking point of 500 degrees. That means if your pan is gonna be too hot, it's really just gonna start smoking. That's how you know it's a little bit too hot. So you turn it down and then it shouldn't be like that. But still, a little bit of smoke's fine. Just flip the bread in there a couple times. You don't want to keep it in there too long or else it's going to get soggy as fuck. Light spray. Flipping, if you flip it too soon, what happens is the egg white on it, it's going to be still wet. So half of it's gonna be stuck to the bread, half of it will be to the pan. I don't know if that's just like me, but I fucked it up. But you let it all cook and then you can flip it on. Sometimes with the other breads, it doesn't really happen too much with the Texas toast because it's so thick, but with the other bread, since it's not as thick, some of the egg white will run out of the sides. So then what you do is you kind of scoop it together and then it's gonna be kind of messy. I'll show you after. We're just gonna do the Texas toast, get that one out of the way first. So, you're gonna know when the toast is fucking done when it looks like goddamn French toast. Fuck yeah, yes! I burned through these freaking things like nobody's business. Light spray. There we go. Now that whole entire beginning part was so slow for me. Dear God, it's making me feel awkward. Maybe I should just wear gloves, you know? All the time. I don't have to wash my hands. Let's keep a little hand sanitizer in there. So earlier I was talking about if there's the lighter bread, it's going to, not fully absorb all the egg whites, so you have to kind of scrape the sides. Sometimes it'll happen with this. And that's why if you look at some of the fridge toast, it looks like scramby eggs is all around it. That's it. Oh yeah. If you throw these bitches on the side of the pan and they kind of crinkle up, don't even bother it. Like, don't touch it. Because what happens is, like, you'll try scraping it off and it'll slide off and the whole bottom side will come out. And it's just a huge mess. It's, yeah. And then you don't ever want to post it on Instagram. And no one wants to, like, see how you cook. The same. Take this.
Okay, that's a little burnt, so I would just show that side.
If you're trying to bulk, use the Texas toast. Throw on peanut butter. Boom, that's easy calories. Easy. If you really want a rundown, I will, like, I'm gonna make another video on it. On how to put it into your fitness bell. Hopefully I'll sound less awkward. I'm just a little tired, that's it. One thing that I noticed also, making videos, I am all over the place. I'll say one thing and then I'll go to the next thing and then I just like won't even finish what the fuck I was saying in the beginning, but then I'll just keep talking. Like, I think in my head I finished the sentences, but then I guess later on when I like watch myself, I'm like, god damn, I wonder why no one really knows what I'm talking about. Cool, boom, this is a lot better. So the last two are gonna probably be ugliest because you're gonna have to pour the extra of the egg whites on top of it. So, I have like that much left. Just pour it on top. That's all. Boom, that's all of it. Let me cut this real quick, edit all that bullshit out, and then I will get down to calories real quick. All right, I am done. Took way too long, took a lot longer than I thought, but here it is. So we have the Texas toast, and then the 45 calorie bread one. So, pretty good. I'm gonna break this down real quick. So for the Texas toast, I had to write this down because I'm using the phone. All of this is 773 calories. So you could split that up into two meals or a breakfast, two breakfasts, whichever. The carbs are gonna be 112.6 if you want to be exact. The fat is 5.1 grams of fat. That's crazy. And the protein is 65.2 grams. And if you have MyFitnessPal, I will show you guys how to log that in later on. But with this, you could put one of these are gonna be about, what, 155 calories, 13 grams of protein. The fat is 1 gram of fat for this. Or actually, wait. Yeah. 1 gram of fat and then 22 grams of carbs. I don't really count carbs. Ketosis is the only thing that I would be doing that for, but there you go. One of these. I like it. And then the second one, a lot more volume. And surprisingly, this bread has a lot more protein than the other one. It's just on whichever one you like better. This one has 633 calories, so that's about 110 calories less than what the Texas toast has. So that's why I say if you're bulking, that one's kind of the go-to. It's a lot denser, I guess you could say. Calories, already said that. Carbs are 88.6. So still for 600. We're not counting carbs. Fat is 4.1, 1 gram fat less than the Texas toast, but still the protein is 74.2, which is about 10 grams more than the Texas toast. So one of these, MyFitnessPal, you're gonna be doing 1/8, and that's gonna be one of these. So if you only wanna like snack on one of these, then you put 1/8, and what the calories for that is 79, protein is 9.3, fat is 0.5. Like, that's like nothing. You could have like Cheeto dust blown in your fucking face and you have more fat from that thing than this. And this is super filling. So for 633 calories, I mean, holy shit. That's already, what? Let's say if you're a girl and you're trying to weigh 125 pounds and you're gonna be eating around 100, I don't know, 15 to 25 grams of protein a day. This is more than half of what you need in the day. Yeah, I did the math right. So there's that. Other things to eat this with. Syrup to keep the calories lower. Sugar-free syrup. This one has 5 calories per 2 tablespoons. So that's about nothing. This one tastes really good. And sooner or later you get used to it and it doesn't make a difference between the regular one or that, the taste wise. I mean, at least for me. There's also this one, Weldon Farms. That is 0 calories. And with this, this is a maple walnut. Pretty good. It's a little bit more liquidy than the other ones, but I prefer the sugar-free, but then the Weldon Farm does do that. And then for butter, this one, it does say it's 0 calories, but like I said earlier, nothing is completely 0 calorie. I think it's per 5 sprays is like 9 calories. So the reason why it gets away with saying 0 calories is because it's 1 spray. So you add up those sprays, they do add up into a certain amount of calories. So even though you're eating 0 calorie meals, don't ever forget that there are calories in it. But finish it off. There we go. Thanks.